Listen, watch out for tripwires. I bet this whole place is booby-trapped.
I like boobies. Tripwire? Look like this?
Yeah, something like that. Listen, you stay here and I'll go get the idol. Watch out for tripwires. There might be more of them around
here. Tripwires? Look like this?
Looks like a fair trade.
What does that mean? Tonight, to introduce our program, we're honored to have Miss Broomfield 1985.
And she's a doozy. You'll love her.
Hi. I'm Tamas Sue Ellen Mae Johnson. You're Miss Broomfield 1985. Besides acting as an emissary of goodwill and role model for the young women of Broomfield, it's also my proud duty to introduce this year's the fourth Nowhere Near Annual Homie Awards. You know, this reminds me of when I was practicing my boom.
Wait a minute, you're not Miss Broomfield?
We told you to get out of here.
Hey, no, she couldn't make it, man. She's christening a bowling ball over Tri-City, you know. Something more important than this. Yeah?
Well, we'll see you later. Thanks for coming.
Hey, well,
back to manpower. Have you pick this guy up?
You gonna give me like $3?
Yeah.
Right after the show.
We'll see if it was worth it by the end. Yo, so this is, as he said in his own way,
yeah, he tried to say. The fourth Nowhere Near Annual Homie Awards. And, great, thank you.
Thanks, Mom. Whoa.
Yeah, there's a beer.
I told you, it was a good thing we brought those seals.
Good thing we invited all our relatives.
I know. Thanks, Ma.
This is Billy Barty. I'm Rupert Pupkin with you tonight. And Bill and Nick have the week off.
Yeah, why don't you tell them why this is the fourth Nowhere Near Almost Annual, Almost Didn't Happen But Happened Anyway Homie Awards.
Well, it's a long story.
Well, then don't tell them.
This is the longest running series on Channel 12, but once in a while we get way behind because it's a volunteer effort on the part of all the crew and the hosts. And so this was supposed to happen last May, so pretend that it's nice and warm in May and you'll enjoy this show tonight.
It could be a bad night in May. But anyway, let's talk about the Homie Awards. Who's eligible?
People are eligible tonight for Homie Awards, and I hope that we can get a shot. Well, we got one of them right here on the podium. But we're going to be giving away six of these little babies, beauties tonight, for six categories that we feel are deserving of people to win awards in. Now, the films that are being judged tonight fell between the shows of April the 21st of 1984 and April the 20th of 1985. And during that time, 90 films were submitted to be shown on the Home Movies show. And of that 90, 24 are in nomination tonight for awards.
All right, this is a public access, public participation show. So if you haven't seen it before and you have a movie of any quality, level of quality, you can submit it as well evidence tonight. And you have a possibility of winning one of our six awards, which are going to be for Best Actor, Best Actress.
Also, Most Promising Filmmaker.
Okay, we've got a special for Best Special Effects. That's usually a case of doing the most with the least as far as money goes.
And that also encompasses animation. We put those two together this year into one category. We're doing 6 this time instead of 12. You know, times are tough. Gold's expensive.
I know. So we can only afford 6 of these this time. We also give an award every year for my favorite category, and that's the worst.
Ooh.
For the absolutely the worst movie of the year. Now, it's not easy to get into this category. You don't just have to be, what, inept?
Or...
or boring,
stupid.
Or incompetent. It takes a certain flair, a certain finesse to get into this category. And there's so many films which do have maybe 1, 2 small redeeming qualities, and they're knocked off immediately. To find the purity, to find the quintessence of the bad movie really takes some searching. And I think you people who are nominated for worst this year should be proud and pleased to be here with us. Because, hey, I would rather see a truly awful movie and sit through it than one that was truly mediocre.
Really?
This is sort of the Plan 9 from Outer Space on a junior scale.
And yes.
Or any movie that Sting or Pia Zadora have ever been in.
Look at all the money Roger Corman made with awful movies that people went to see anyway. You aren't a starving artist. You're a rich capitalist, and you know it doesn't matter if you make trash. So, anyway, that should get almost anybody onto this show, and we've had quite a few on. In fact, one of the previous worst home movie winners is here tonight, Eric Thomas Wenzel, and he mentioned he had to be incompetent to make a bad home movie, so thanks for the advice.
And that's something that doesn't come naturally, I might add. And finally, we will be giving an award, in all seriousness, for the best home movie of the year. Keeping in mind the financial and technical constraints these people have to work with, I think you'll see some clips of some remarkable movies tonight.
And here are the envelopes, and those each contain the winner in the different categories. Now, these were chosen by our home movie staff, but we also had a show on the 14th of December where we took calls from the viewers, and we considered their votes as well when we came up with our winners.
You can let us know what you think. I think right now, let's go into the clips for Best Actor in a Home Movie 1985.
Enjoy.